Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss how to perform interactive coding using NVivo. Interactive coding is the method to code the documents manually by going through each document and highlighting the words or phrases relating to a specific theme. It is a tedious process but necessary to ensure the quality of code. This method only works for qualitative analysis with limited textual data. If you have a very large textual data set, then text mining using machine learning is required to extract information from big data. It is a more complicated process since we need to go through multiple steps of filtering to make sure the information extracted from the text is valid. I will cover it in the next course, DAV 724. In this course, we do not cover text mining and focus more on manual coding. First, let's review our user profile again to make sure we know which user profile the codes are linked to. Go to Files and Preferences. We can see the username and initial here. The initial will show up in the coding comparison with multiple coders. Let's see the interview reports we have. As we can see in these documents, these interviews are very unstructured, and each document has different interviewers and different questions. In several cases, the interviewers changed the question as they went on with the interviews. Hence, auto-coding will not work for this dataset since it will miss many important details and will likely produce messy and meaningless results. Of course, auto-coding is easier and faster, but it will only work with structured questions and in some cases does not allow us to look deeper in the document content, which may raise questions about the reliability and validity of the code. And in reality, we usually have unstructured interview reports rather than structured ones. Thus, we will need to perform interactive coding in this case. Using interactive coding is a great method to explore the qualitative data and develop a new theory or hypothesis. Theme notes are the themes or topics from your source materials. These notes could be descriptive or analytical. You might already know the topics that you're exploring when you begin your research, or you might identify themes that emerge as you code your sources. You can also organize notes in hierarchies, parent and child notes to organize your materials and consolidate your thinking. Typically, there are two ways to come up with the note hierarchy. In the first approach, we review the literature and find a relevant framework that applies to our topic. We use this framework to develop our note hierarchy. If such a framework does not exist in the literature, then the second way is to develop a preliminary note hierarchy from a combination of literature and our knowledge of the topic. Then we use several SMEs to verify the note hierarchy, consisting of primary themes, factors or constructs related to our topic. As we code the data to those nodes, we can make adjustments to the node hierarchy, such as adding new nodes, removing existing nodes, or revising current nodes. In this example, we will look at certain perspectives of the data, but not all, because the data contains a lot of different information related to researchers. For example, focus on the attitude toward becoming a researcher and impact factors. Suppose you review relevant literature and theory regarding these issues and develop a preliminary note hierarchy for this project based on the theory and our understanding of the topic. Note hierarchy has parent notes and child notes. The first parent note is attitude toward being a researcher, which has two child notes, negative and positive. The second parent note is benefits, with two child notes, intellectual and creativity, and source on practical contributions. The third parent note is challenges with two child notes, time requirements and work pressure. The final parent note is, in this example, support, which has three child notes, showing support from colleagues, family, and supervisor. Now we have a preliminary note structure. We can enter this into NVivo, go through all documents and code the data based on this node structure or hierarchy. Again, as you code the data, you can modify the node hierarchy to make it fit better. This should be an iterative process. For the purpose of this video, we assume that This is finalized, not structure. We're back to NVivo. Let's see how to create the node hierarchy. On the Create tab, click Code and select New Code. In the Code Properties window, we enter the name for the new node in the name box, which attitude toward being a researcher. You can choose to enter a description of the node in the description box. This can help ensure consistent coding, particularly useful if you work in a team. By default, this will be a parent node. We see a checkbox saying aggregating coding from child nodes. Aggregating coding means when working with nodes in a hierarchy, you can gather all the materials in child nodes and roll it up to the parent node. You will check this box. Click Done. On the left panel, select codes, and we can see the created node. Then we create the remaining parent nodes following the same process. We will have benefits, then we have challenges, and finally we have support. I noticed later a misspelling in my first node. Sorry about that. To add child nodes, first we select a parent node, in this case attitude toward being a researcher, and then right click and choose new code. As we can see in location, the path shows the new node will be a child node of this parent node. So we enter positive in the name and click Done. The node structure shows that positive is the child node of attitude toward being a researcher. Since we do not have another level of child nodes, we do not check the aggregate coding box in this case. We do the same to create another child node, negative. Then we'll repeat the entire process for all other child nodes based on the node hierarchy we developed before. Please make sure to always double check the path in the location for the name and parent node to make sure we have the correct node hierarchy in NVivo. To perform the interactive coding, we go back to the interviews folder. Then we double click on Andrew to open his interview report. The actual document appears in the window. If you have many large documents to go through, the process could be tedious and time consuming. However, for the exploratory research, the sample size is usually limited, so this task is doable. This interactive coding process could result in a very useful and insightful findings that you cannot obtain from auto-coding. This will help you develop your model or hypothesis later. If you have to deal with a very large database of qualitative data and the interactive coding is not feasible, a technique such as text mining using SAS Enterprise Miner could be used. In this example, I will demonstrate how to perform interactive coding with Andrew's interview report. The process is the same for others. Andrew was a beginning researcher, having completed an honor degree in science at New York University 1 year prior to this interview. In the first part, he described his life, his background, and the reason that led him to choose his major. This part is interesting but not really relevant to the purpose of this example. As we continue to read through the interview, we see his description of the support he received from his supervisor. So we highlight the relevant text, select the code button on top, which will open the window showing existing nodes. Then we see all existing nodes. We'll select code support supervisor. It will link the highlighted text to that child node. We do the same for support from colleagues in a slightly different way. Highlight the text, right click, select code selection, and two existing codes or cases. We'll see all nodes in the node hierarchy. We just need to select the right child node and click select. I will code another text to challenges, work pressures using same steps. It is the text stating that he also had to spend a lot of time working on research. Let's say we miscoded and want to undo what we did. We can use uncode selection feature. For example, I want to uncode the work pressure node. We will right click on the entry name, select uncode selection, select chai node we coded recently, which is work pressure, then click select. As we see here, the code had been uncoded. However, in this case, it is the correct code, so I will code it again. Also, we want to find a text that link the positive and the attitude toward being a researcher. There is a question about career path, and his answer is somewhat mixed. He stated that he was enjoying doing research, but the frustration comes from the funding. For example, we can interpret that he has a positive attitude toward being a researcher because he is really enjoying it. That is a positive attitude. And we highlight the text and connect it to positive note under attitude. That's an example of how to perform interactive coding. If we repeat the same process for all interviews, then we have the complete coding to save time. I did all coding off the scene, and this is the final coding for this example. We can view our codes graphically using coding stripes. We select coding stripes and choose all. Basically, coding stripes are color bars display alongside source or node content that allows you to see how the content is coded. By clicking on the stripes, you can see the text content of that code. So that is how to perform interactive coding using NVivo. Thank you and bye now.